Hi guys, I'm Nosadan and we are playing OpenTTD. Okay, so the last episode we improved our call distribution here. The rating is 60%, it's quite good. That's good, that's very good. Here the rating is 36% for whatever reason. So here it actually dropped. That's not really that good to hear, I have to admit. Well, I could just buy another train and that would most likely help. And I might actually do that. Okay, so we'll need train thingies and we'll need from the from here. And yeah, go and earn your money. Go, earn money. Okay, cool, so it's going. And now, last episode we were discussing the idea of having here a metro around the city. So I think we'll be actually doing that right now. That sounds like a quite cool thing to do right now. So I think we'll make two metro stations for the Penwood, and one will be on the north and the other one will be on the west south side, so basically here, and it will be directly tapping here. I have no clue how I will actually go and fit it here, so that will be actually very cool. Okay, so narrow gauge tracks. At first, I think we'll start with this kind of configuration. So basically, two tracks only. We'll try to make it more prone to extensions, but we'll see. Okay, so we will. We will put it here. So from here, we'll have to actually provide it a way to, well, get passengers. How we will do that? Because here we'll be having the input and here we'll have the output, I think. And that seems like a way to do. How to do it in a logical way. So how we could do that, because here we could have the it doesn't really play with my original plan that well to have a station here, or at least not that not this close. Maybe I will actually remove this one. I will remove this one and I will try to make a better communication here, because here we'll also need a road here, and here also would be nice, but we can do it like that. Okay, okay, we'll match. We'll basically make one T section and then we'll immediately make another T section. That's the idea. Okay, go on. Come on. Okay, and here we'll need like 1, 2, 3. Completely not this way. Okay. Okay, and I will have to remove this sign in either way. Actually. Here we need a tunnel here and here, and now we need to make the actual signals. Yes, 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 yes. Okay, so we are nearly done with here. Okay, so here we have our T-section, that's very nice. I was kind of worried if I will actually be able to do it before something will just go and crash to something else. But we managed, so that's very cool. Okay, so now here we will need an additional T-section, I think. Because I don't think we can actually make a four-way here, and I don't think we would be actually willing to do that, so yeah. Either ways. Okay, so how we will merge those kind of things to be very compact, because we don't have I don't really want to spend that much space here. We'll do that by making a yeah, I could do that like that. Okay. From what I could say, this should work just perfectly fine. Maybe, I don't know. I never actually tried this thing like that, really. Okay, so now we need this, and here we have some kind of bye-bye. And okay, like this. And here we also have one too much, okay. I really like building this kind of very compact rail systems. It's for me like a puzzle. Every time that I'm building something like that, I always feel like I'm solving some kind of puzzle. How to optimize something. I really like those kind of things, so I don't really mind doing something like that. So that's very okay. Here, and I forgot about this one here, and this one. Oh, that's actually a very cool design, I would say. Here, and here. Okay, so we are done with another T-section. That's very cool that we could actually pull it off. Really, I didn't know that it would actually if it would actually fit here, but it seems that it fits just like a glove. So that's very cool. So now here we can make a roller station for the passengers here, and also maybe in the future some cargo, but really small cargo, I think. Maybe something for like the distributing of food. And this one is for the also for the food, so maybe, but I'm not convinced that it will be something that will be actually doing that that much. Okay, but the input is like that, and the output is like that. So basically, here we have the problem that the output is in the way that we don't really want. How we can remedy it? I don't know yet. Okay, but we'll try to put a station here-ish. Yeah, and they don't really like that idea. But why? It will give you a lot of money and so it's very poor, really. Okay, so I will just throw at you a lot of trees and you will be happy. It's still poor. And it's better. Okay. So we'll make the station here, and I think here will be the okay location for the station. So it will be our roller station, as most of our stations. And for now, it will be just something like that. And I'm not happy that I'm really not happy that we would have to actually go and. Yes, how we will make the roller station happen? I have like no clue how I would actually like to do that here. Give me a second to think. Maybe something like that. because I want to have here a bus stop, actually quite a bus stops. So yeah, that's why I don't like that we have the output here. Places, not really that much, but yeah, it will do. It will do. Yeah, go away. Actually, no. Don't do anything here. It's fine. Okay. So here. And then here, and here, and here, and here. Okay, so this would be our first metro station that we'll be actually using here. Of course, there is no metro yet, because, well, there's no metro. Actually, here we'll make a additional bus stops, and that will be also our metro. Here, also. That makes sense, why to do that. Okay. Now, where we could... It would be nice to have additional metro station somewhere here, but... Or maybe not, actually, I don't know. I'm not convinced about that much. But I would like to have a metro station here at the north, also here, somewhere here. I think it would make sense why to do it. But then I would have to T-section somewhere here. Oh, another puzzle, right? Another puzzle. I just have to love those puzzles. Let me see what we can do about it here. Either way, this thing will be remodeled to actually have, because here it would be nice to also have a metro station. So basically we'll have like three cities and one is growing very nicely. And I would like to enable them to have a metro connection between them and also these ones. So most likely we'll have a narrow gauge metro system around here, and yeah, some kind of maybe like a train, a real train connection system would be also here. Well, either ways we'll have to make it here. I just don't want to overgrow the cities right now because I will need a lot of space, and it's better to actually, well, yeah, have the space before the cities are overgrown. Here I know what I will do, and that's very cool. Here I don't know what I will do, and that's not that cool. Okay, I will try by putting a station here. And then I will try to think about how I will actually do and patch it up, or all the things I will actually patch up here. I don't know yet, so that's why, yeah. I will start with the station. Okay, and basically I will need some roads here also, either ways. And most likely we'll have here not really that big station. Okay, something like that here. here. And that would require from me doing here a tunnel. Yeah, here a tunnel. That will be something that I will require. And this thing will actually be the input, and here we'll have the output, right? That's the idea. Okay, now we need the tunnels here. Actually, I could make something like that here, and this will have additional advantage by with a form that in a form that the train would not have to go on the slope twice. So that's very nice, because trains do slow down on the slopes when they are climbing them also. So. Usually, I am trying to make as less slopes as it is possible. It's not always possible, of course, but I'm trying to do my best about that. And here we can also do something like that. So basically, we can actually maximize the efficiency of the space here, and that would make sense actually to do that. This kind of entry input output thingies are not really that efficient, but. Yeah, it's a narrow gauge thingy. It's not like it will have to do like millions of passengers, or at least I actually hope so, because if it will, then we are basically toasted. Here we have the only problem that it's basically a terminal station, so it doesn't have a good way to expand the road from here. But nevertheless, we will try to do something intelligent here. And I am not so sure how we'll do that. Well, for the first, this thing will be a problem, that's for sure. The other thing is that I have more problems actually here. Yeah, I have more problems. I think I will have to bulldoze the river here. Yeah, we'll have to. And then here we can actually make a additional track that we need. Okay, this will not stay like this, and how will it do that? And how will it do that? Well, this thing will have to be... how it will be? Because if I would like to have those here also, then I would have to have this thing in a completely different direction. And to have it, this thing in a completely different direction, I would have to actually alter how this works. And that's not really that ideal. Okay, never. Yeah, okay, so we will have more work here than I anticipated at first. The problem here is that the problem here is that we will need this kind of things. But then it will go here. What? So how this thing works? Because those are basically T sections with a very long middle. Okay, so basically here it will work like here and here, and then it can go back here, or it can. Okay. I messed up this thing because it should have also this thing. So basically, I cannot put the last thing here, or maybe I could actually. Yeah, why not? Ah, see? I almost made a very, very dire mistake. Okay. So here will be the same idea. Deployed, and we will have to get rid of those bridges that I didn't know why they are even here. So that's very cool. Glad that we have one thing resolved. And here we'll have this kind of thing. Going on for us. And here also would be nice to have this kind of thing. Okay. And wait a second. I have to do it like this. Yeah, I told you guys, it's a puzzle. It's a puzzle. Basically, OpenTTD is a puzzle game. But a very fun one. Nevertheless, it's a very fun puzzle game. I really like it. It's one of my favorite games. Yeah, this one here also. And here also ish. Yeah, also ish. Okay, and then here this one, and then we'll just need tunnels, and then something like this here. And here, and here. And that's very cool. Here we'll just make a loop. Okay, so now we can live with it. Now we can live with this one. And let us start putting signals. I have a friend that I'm sometimes I'm playing OpenTTD with, and he's and he basically built the railroad as he needs them, and he doesn't actually go like and plan ahead about what is the implication of putting the rail here or there or whatever. So usually it's actually working for him quite okay. The only problem is the late game. Because the late game, in the late game, it's very important to have a very flexible railroad system. That's the most important thing, actually, I think. Because when you have like, I don't know, 100 trains that are going through one system, and it's very intertwined and so on, you cannot even try to foresee which parts of the tracks are actually essential to a system and which aren't. Well, you can actually kind of see it by the traffic, but it's not really that that a good idea to actually just like rely on the just like observing the traffic and seeing where is where the traffic is heavier and where not. Because sometimes when you would basically isolate a system into part of the system and then make two systems, then automatically it will congest on the entries for those kind of two systems. And if that does, then it will just congest the next node and next one. So that will actually go and in an avalanche effect, and immediately like the roads, the tracks that you thought that they are completely okay when it comes to congestion, so automatically they are just congested and nothing is running through them. So what I want to say that when I'm building roads, I'm sometimes putting like extra thingy, extra inputs, outputs. So for example here, we don't really need this bit, no, but I know that in the future we will need it. So I am already making my system as we would actually need it right now. It's mostly because it simplifies stuff. It really simplifies stuff. So that's why I'm doing this kind of thing. And here we have the last problem, and the last problem is to somehow go and connect this bit to this bit. So basically, so we'll have like this. Yeah. I don't know really how to do it right now. That's not ideal. That's not ideal, I would assume. I would say that's not really that ideal. But here we can do some kind of trick, I think, to get the roads where I want or not. Yeah, I kinda could do. And then here, and then now still not that much space to work with. And I'm not really that happy about that, but we could try to do that. Can we actually manage that? Because then we'll have this kind of thing going on here, basically something like that, and then we have this thing, and this thing, and this thing, and this, and then we'd have this, and this, and this, and then we'll have. This. Yeah, okay, we are doing with this thing. Okay, so here I need a T section. I will need a T section, either ways. And here we'll just make an underground tunnels. It's not ideal for capacity, but yeah, not really that much space here. So we'll go in underground tunnels. What can you do about that, right? What can you do? Okay, how will we manage that? We will actually manage that by making... something here differently. And something here differently, I would assume that it would be... I don't know yet what. Okay, so this would... No, that's one too much. And of course I just burned through like 30,000. Yeah. So, planning is a very big part of this game. To actually plan stuff before you put them. Oh, yeah. No, this will not work like that. Well, okay, that's not really a problem because we'll just actually fix this stuff here, and we'll just make a bridge, and then we'll have enough space to actually do all the things that we want. So, for example, here and here, and here we'll have the bridge. And this would this one, why not? Looks nice. No, not really, but it will do. And okay, and here we'll have the tracks again, and here we'll have like this kind of tracks, and go on and be happy. Okay, okay. Now here we will need a tunnel, of course. Ugh. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay, and okay, and here we'll have the tunnel, and here, whoops, and only the signaling, and we are done here. And here, and here, and here, and here, and here, and here, and just two additional tracks, please. Thank you very much. Okay, so we are nearly done with this part, and nearly done. And we'll just connect those things here. Yeah, I thought that it would be. Yeah, it's a very close call how it will be actually connected and so. But yeah, what can you do? Actually, here we can do a little better job, and we'll do that. But this will mean that we will have our connection as we want, and that's a very good news. And the music in this game is really gorgeous. In the past, I used to have a some kind of new GFR that was also adding like a song by children, like a choo-choo sound, and it was just so really cute. But I don't know which one it was. Okay, so we prepared our communication network for having a subway, basically. Well, not a subway, it's more like a metro thingy. So, not this episode, but next episode, we'll actually set up all the lines, and we'll have our subway communication and intercity communications and those kind of things. Well, it's not really an intercity train, but it will be something like that. So, like it if you like it, subscribe if you really, really like it, and well, see you next time. So, cheers!